about time.
What's going on? Yeah.
Rumor report, rumor report.
This is the Rumor Report.
Talk to him.
With Angela Yee on The Breakfast Club.
Well, Rihanna has a book coming out. It's a visual autobiography with over 1,000 photos, which documents her career, and it's 504 pages. It will also have snapshots from her childhood in Barbados, her worldwide tours, her fashion moments, and private time with friends and family. She said, "I'm so excited to share this collection of incredible images. I'm very grateful to the talented photographers and artists who contributed. We've been working on the book for over 5 years, and I'm really happy to be able to finally share it with everybody."
That's smart.
So they're saying this book weighs about 15 pounds, and it costs $175, so you can pre-order the Rihanna book on Rihanna's website now.
That's smart. A picture book of Rihanna? Who wouldn't grab that?
Mm-hmm.
It's a dope coffee
table. Listen,
I'm
into it. And they're saying the book is also going to get a big album release party, of course, at the Guggenheim Museum, and that's going to be happening Friday in New York City.
Okay.
All right, now, Tiny, T.I.'s wife Tiny, she's had at least $750,000 worth of jewelry stolen from her over the weekend. The robbery took place while she was grabbing a drink at Bar Amalfi in Atlanta. Mm. She got there in her Lamborghini at 8:45 p.m. She went to the bar. She didn't realize her property was missing until she came back to her vehicle around 11:45 p.m. And that's when they confirmed that the Atlanta Police Department says she did report theft of her jewelry.
I mean, there was a lot going on in Atlanta this weekend. You had the BET Hip Hop Awards. You had that, I think it was a film festival on Sunday. You had the Tyler Perry grand opening.
She had all that in her car?
Yeah, she said it was in a blue velour bag that was on top of the center console of her Lamborghini SUV. Her friend went to the car to grab a deck of cards, and Tiny says her friend had no idea that was in the car. The jewelry was in there. There was no sign of forced entry. There was no damage to the vehicle.
I'm sure the wolves were out this weekend.
Absolutely.
But I know that they need to return T.I.'s wife's items expeditiously, okay? I'm sure T.I. made a couple phone calls.
Speaking of Atlanta, let's talk about Tyler Perry. And he's discussing squashing his beef with Spike Lee. You know, taking the high road. We told you already that he did actually name one of the sound studios in honor of Spike Lee. Mm-hmm. And here's what he had to say about that.
You cannot deny what he has done in the film industry and how he's been on the forefront to help me and everybody else get to the place where we are. So, you know, Spike called me a few years ago when he came to my house, flew down Atlanta. We sat down, we had a great conversation. And the beauty is, that's what I'm hoping that people will understand. Like, when Oprah and I worked together, it was a huge moment. But this moment for me and Spike is a huge moment. So I'm hoping that we as people start to come together and understand that, hey, everything's all right. Everything's cool. You can have your opinion, I can have mine, but we all are going in the same direction. So I just wanted to honor him for what he's done.
That's dope.
Hey, man, Tyler's leading by example.
I respect that.
Right, Spike Lee had once called the Madea franchise coonery and buffoonery, so now they've made up.
Well, Spike and Tyler didn't have a real issue. It was just a matter of, you know, difference of opinion when it comes to the type of art they make. But people like that can do more together than apart. Tyler got the studio, Spike got the creative, and they can collab on something amazing.
All right, now Ellen DeGeneres, she was under some heat for sitting next to George W. Bush, former President George W. Bush, at the Dallas Cowboys Green Bay Packers game. On social media, people were going in on her just because of his views. He's a conservative Republican president. People were upset. She said they thought, why is a gay Hollywood liberal sitting next to a conservative Republican president? Well, here's what she had to say.
I'm friends with George Bush. In fact, I'm friends with a lot of people who don't share the same beliefs that I have. We're all different, and I think that we've forgotten that that's okay that we're all different. For instance, I wish people wouldn't wear fur. I don't like it, but I'm friends with people who wear fur. But just because I don't agree with someone on everything doesn't mean that I'm not going to be friends with them. When I say be kind to one another, I don't mean only the people that think the same way that you do. I mean be kind to everyone.
Okay, I don't see nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, I don't see the problem. Why are people so afraid to talk to people with a difference of opinion, you know, different beliefs? Like, who wants to be in a constant echo chamber all the time? Social media makes you comfortable with groupthink.
Absolutely.
As long as you have your people who think like you and believe what you believe, then you feel safe. But that doesn't contribute to your growth at all.
I come up here every day and talk to this Cowboys fan. And the fact that he's a Cowboys fan, I don't look at him any different. Maybe I do a little bit.
There you guys go.
I look at you different for a number of reasons. Okay, not just your sports teams.
What?
It's really the beige rage, to be honest with you. But it just reinforces every negative stereotype I had about light-skinned men. I'm sorry. I know y'all hate colorism. But if it's not a stereotype, if it's true.
Well,
I don't mind if you're a Cowboys fan.
Let's move on and let's talk about Sky from Black and Crew. She got into it with a New York City taxi driver who cut her off in traffic. She actually jumped out of her car and got in the cab driver's face basically ready to fight. They're saying the cab had nearly sideswiped her vehicle, and she did have her security with her. And she posted, "Hey, what's up? I usually don't address these sort of things. However, I'm in a place in my life where accountability is important. The video floating around featuring the taxi driver and I exchanging of words is being misconstrued. There's more to the story than what's being seen. This driver recklessly hits myself and my loved ones. We attempted a peaceful resolution and he jumped off the deep end, which caused me to react. If you know me, my love for people runs deep. In no way, shape, or form do I think my reaction was perfect. It was provoked. I do want it to be known, being from New York, my love for taxi drivers and the public transportation system runs deep. It's been more pleasant run-ins than that. Either way, I'm moving in from this situation knowing I could have handled it better."
I've never heard anybody say they actually loved the taxi driver.
No, what she did was, why do people apologize? I'm tired of people apologizing. The taxi cab cut her off. They got into an argument. The taxi cab got a little crazy. Her security yoked them up. There is no reason to apologize.
Well, she was yelling at her security guard, "Beat his ass! Beat his ass!"
Well, maybe he needed his ass.
Maybe
he needed
I don't know. She was all in his face. The taxi cab driver grabbed him first. Yeah, beat his ass.
I don't know the full context
of
the story. So I'm just talking right
now. You also don't want to put your security in a position where they might get in trouble for beating someone.
I ain't gonna front. Sometimes taxi cab drivers cut you off in a way where they need an ass beating. I'm not gonna lie.
That's not security's responsibility is not to do that. You try to resolve a situation as peacefully as possible.
Taxi cab almost cut me off so crazy, almost crashed and died. Yes, he needs to get his ass beat. Sometimes they drive crazy.
Maybe y'all are misconstruing security with a goon. Because that's a goon's job.
But maybe that's security goon.
You know what I'm saying? You don't want those. You don't want goonerity.
Goonerity.
You don't want goonerity. You know what I'm saying? You want real
goonery,
security.
I would say.
No, security, yes.
Hey, goon, you don't want a goon security. You don't want goonerity.
Goonerity.
You don't want goonerity.
I got what you're saying.
They can escalate a situation.
Sagoonery. There you go.
Sagoonery.
Sagoonery. You don't want sagoonery. It's a lot of people out there that have sagoons.
All right, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your rumor report.
Sagoonery instead of security.
Sagoonery.
Okay? You don't want no sagoonery.